Welcome to the Lauda Cross Country and Biathlon Centre. Wonderful to have you with us on what is looking a very busy day indeed, because we're bringing you the men's and women's sprints. There's some wet snow falling, as you can see, which is going to make life interesting for the course maintainers and the athletes, and to some degree the spectators as well. So better snow than rain, but it certainly gets in the face and down the neck and in your eyes, and but it's all part of the fun of winter sports. So yes, we have potentially 24 races today in the cross-country sprints qualifying semis and finals. So there's an initial look. There are the six finals as well. So this is one busy day ahead of us. That's all right. We're here for the fun, and there's going to be lots of action. And at the end of the day, six new champions. So men's and women's sitting, standing, and vision impaired. Quite a process to get us down to the finals, but it's about to get underway with the men's 1K sprint sitting category. The snow, the soft air temperature, 3 degrees. And very high humidity, not much wind. Our friends the mascots are out on the course with a very good view of what's about to take place here. 24 starters in the men's sprint sitting qualification. They will go off at 30 second intervals, and kicking us off, we've got some very well credentialed athletes. Gauthier Book, Rocca, Rossier, and towards the end of the field, we certainly have the more one of the favourites, shall we say, of the event. Sol of the USA. He's been skiing very well in cross-country and biathlon events. Roman Petushkov to go last. Down the snow comes with a diagonal breeze. It's not very strong, but it's certainly strong enough to affect the direction of the snow. Maxim Yorovyi. He's been doing well in the biathlon. He's in some kind of form. Irek Zadapov, who was second in Vancouver in the sprint. Daniel Nossen. Larsen of Norway. Got a range of sport classes here, from 11.5, 10, and 12, and all their times are factored accordingly, so that we've got a level playing field. Protected from the elements today. It's going to be a long day of competition, but an exciting one. Fernando Rocca. He's complaining about the cold. The Brazilian. It's cool for him. So Sebastian Fortier, his sporting hero, is the great ice hockey player from Canada, Sidney Crosby. If we channel a bit of Sidney Crosby's brilliance, I think he'll have a good day. And Sebastian Fortier of Canada, the 27-year-old, is on his way from Quebec. It's his second Paralympic Winter Games. So it takes some finding the tracks today. Every time they're cleared, they're filled with snow again. In some ways, this is a good to see, because we've had the snow wearing away. Ebook next to go, another Canadian. So one and two out of the gates. 48-year-old father of four. He's 48-0 out on the course, negotiating one of the early bends. And you see the amount of loose snow on the surface just being sprayed away by the sliding turn of Sebastian Fortier. Fernando Roca next to go. And he trained in Colorado in February this year, the Brazilian, to help prepare himself for the events here in Laura and in Sochi. He's under US coach Mark Abbott, who is here for the games. And Fernando Roca from Sao Paulo. Vladimir Gaditsia, Slovakia, he's on his way. Fortier, meanwhile, out on the course. Snow in the face. Goggles very important today. Make sure you've got them with you and you pack your kit. Well, not necessarily. As you see, Travis Dodson happy to try without them. He's born in Silver City but lives in Champaign, Illinois. A health science degree from the University of Illinois. And Travis on his way, 58 years of age now. Lovely to see the trees draped in snow. Alexander Koniko, the Ukrainian from Kiev, participated in last year's World Championships in Sweden. Enjoys weightlifting and swimming and a bit of arm wrestling. So these are just the short races. 1 kilometre time trial, effectively. And in comes Eve Book. Fortier was through in 2:43.7. Eve Book coming down. We finish straight now, and everything is getting covered in snow. Even the hoardings between the spectators and the main straight here. The book outside the time of Fortier by 7 seconds. So will he make the semi-finals? Time will tell us. Rocker pushing down hard. There's a new good time, and Rocker certainly given it everything, hasn't he? He might have to hold back a little bit if he's going to survive the semis and perhaps make a final. But he's got some time to recover. And that will be the key. Vladimir Gaditsia, Slovakian from Zelina. Been around a while, participated in Salt Lake, Torino and Vancouver. Just outside Rocker's time. Dodson will be next to come in, and he is going to come in under Rocker's 2:29. Just, perhaps not. Gonna push it into the finish here, 2:29 to beat Rocker, and he does. 1.62 inside that time. Well, he's opted to go without glasses or goggles, and I guess it's a short race, under 3 minutes. Warnico pushing down towards the line, and he'll come in under Dodson's time. So they're seated on the expectation of how they'll go. Will he make it inside? Yes, he does, just. Eleven is Mikhailo Tachenko of Ukraine. coming in, Aaron Pike. He's in the London Paralympics in track and field. Interesting background. He's educated in Germany. And Pike threw in 2:20.86. So he's got the new quickest time as out of the gate goes Dmitry Loban of Belarus. Kosiek. Camille Kosiek comes through in 2:23.9. That's the second quickest time so far. Volcharov. The Russians giving him a big cheer as he makes his way to the line. He is the first of the Russians to venture out onto the course. And I think we've got a new best time coming in here from Goncharov. Romain Rozic of France. Rozic, born in Strasbourg. Wagner. Out on the course, the American Aaron Pike, we've already seen finish in what is so far the second best time. Goncharov into the top spot, 2:17.64. Wagner 4.7 seconds behind him. So it all happens quite quickly here, the qualifying. We've got 24 men lining up for the 1K sitting sprint. Pachenko, 2:17 to take the top spot, and he's done it by 1.7 seconds. So the time just getting trimmed and trimmed and trimmed. Andrew Sol. And a big, strong, powerfully built American sets off soft new snow to deal with, and help your wax technicians get the surface just right for you and maximize your opportunity, your chance to put in a good time. Down to the line comes Dmitry Loban of Belarus. Outside the time of Tachenko. 4.7 seconds almost. Third best at the moment. John Halstead of the United States. And a big 17, so we've got 18 through 24 still to leave the gate. Martin Flag of Germany. Chris Klebel, former US citizen competing for Canada, has been for the last 3 years. Born in Dusseldorf, grew up in Austria, represented the US for a while, and now Canada. Rozic of France coming down to the line, and those skis aren't gliding too well. This is a real struggle for Rozic. I wonder if he's got the right wax on the skis. He is really labouring. This is not how we would like to be travelling, but Rozic across 17 and a half seconds outside the best time, so he's down in now 13th position. As Lukyanenko comes in pretty handy time, his second quickest, Johanny Lukyanenko of Belarus. Daniel Nossen of the United States sets off. Very quick work with the poles, trying to get up some early momentum. Meanwhile, the other end of the course, in comes another American in Andrew Sol. 2:16 to beat, not quite, and comes across in fifth best time. Grigory Murigin. Saw him in a podium finish at biathlon events. and he's only 19 years of age. Halstead pushing his way to the line. Yes, well represented in this event. Six athletes, in fact. 24 competitors from 11 countries. Irek Zarapov now. 4 years ago, silver medalist in this event. So can he go one better? Canadian Klebel. Just Klebel coming through now. With a new best time of 2:15.63, that looks like good news in terms of making the semi-finals with only a few still out there. 23, Maxim Yarovyi. Larson coming down to the line. Won't beat Klebel's time. He's in seventh position at the moment, Larson. And Petushkov. Well, this man has swept all before him. He's got the three gold medals already from three events. Petushkov. Different conditions for him today. See if he handles them as well as he has the others. Nossen coming down to the line. Got a top five result there in this early qualifying stage of the men's sitting sprint. Or in the Rugin. And the young man, oh, he's flown around the course. He's carved 7 seconds off Klebel's time. And looks like he's got plenty in reserve too. So Merugin, what a talent he is. Already a medalist at his Paralympic Winter Games. We had rain and miserable conditions yesterday with poor visibility. Now we've got this wet snow driving into the faces of the finishing athletes. Zarapov, third last out of the gate. He'll be outside Murigan's time. But second best overall. And just Yarovyi and Petushkov to come. Maxim Yarovyi is LW10, so 86% factoring applied to his time, so essentially 14% off his real time, but that is already considered in the time you're seeing tick by for him. Yarovyi, LW10 is his sport class, coming down to the line, be close to Marigan's time of 2:08.67, and Yarovyi, don't need to get too excited about it just yet. It's just qualifying. He's got the quickest time, but probably not for long as Petushkov comes through and he takes 1.8 seconds off Yarovyi. So there we are. We've got all 24 through. Doesn't take long, does it? In less than 15 minutes. In the field of 24 it was. So we'll wait for the officials to do their work and tell us who's qualified. Looks like we're going to have a top 12 go through. And Larson of Norway might be the one who's lucky 12th, as I'm looking at my screen here. I always like to wait for official qualification. Next up, we'll have the women's sprint qualification. There's not much of a delay between classes and categories here. Baltabaeva will lead them away from Sini Pii of Finland. Birgit Skarstein there in the number 8 bib for Norway. Great spread of nations in the women's sitting sprint qualification. Tatyana McFadden here, a very emotional reunion with her natural mother, who's from Russia, and Tatyana raised primarily in the States after being adopted across there. Anya Vicker, gold medalist in the biathlon. Mariann Marthinsen of Norway to go last.
Yeah.
qualifying. Now to get underway. Great to see a smile on the faces of competitors even before they're about to compete, and they're obviously taking on board the message to Philip Craven about enjoying the time here. Have fun, play hard, play fair, enjoy yourself. We've got to start then in the women's 1K sprint sitting. And Zanil Baltabayeva from Almaty in Kazakhstan leads them away. She's 23 years of age. Sinipei from Rovaniemi in Finland. Multilingual, English, Finnish obviously, French, Swedish. First race I did in sit skiing, she said, was pretty memorable because I was doing what I love again. I competed in cross country before our accident and now after it, so that's quite a journey for Sini Pii. Mayuko Ino from Akita in Japan. One of the younger competitors here. Just 16 years of age. Really attacking the course. And still the snow falls. Sio Barami. Now she is an interesting character. Chosen as a representative of the 2018 Games in Pyeongchang, that's where the next Winter Olympics and Paralympics will be, she's chosen to be a torchbearer for the final leg of the relay for the Paralympic Winter Games in Sochi. And the Pyeongchang region has very special meaning for her because it's her father's hometown. All sorts of wonderful stories come to light as the Games unfold. And Seo of Korea certainly has one. Beth Requist. Used to be a snowboarder before her accident in 2011. Wanted to be outdoors. And so she took up cross country, sit skiing. And 40 there, Natalia Kochareva of the Russian Federation. But next to go, Monica Bastio from Massapequa in the United States originally, now Denver, Colorado. Two silver medals in London in hand cycling. This results behind Andrea Eskau of Germany, who's also in this field. 9 top 10 finishes in cross country and biathlon at Paralympic Winter Games, Torino and Vancouver. Lidia Rafaela next to go. 28-year-old from Belarus. She's got 5 events on her Paralympic program. Into the finish area comes Zanil Baltabayeva. Led out the field for the women's sit skiing sprint qualification, and she is really driving it home. Baltabayeva coming down just beyond 3.5 minutes, her hopefully qualifying time. We'll see. 3:35.74 collapses across the line. I think she gave it everything. That's what you'd expect. She's going to have to... Did she make the finish? She just... Yes, she did. 3:35.74. But only just. Now the Finn coming down. You see the days again are stressed that the wax technicians have such an important job. Humidity, snow conditions, all important when they wax the skis and send out their athletes. Baltabayeva Still got the this time. Their spear comes in 0.62 under that. Eno down to the line. Oh, it's hard work the last 100 metres or so. She's got there. And collapses over her skis. Natalia Kocharova sets off. Mayuka Eno will need to get herself out of the finish area as soon as she's able. She's exhausted with the effort. Here's our friend, Fio Vorami, torch carrier. Sochi Games. And someone closely associated with Pyeongchang. Fio in with the new best time, ever so narrowly, and that's the twist. Comes across. Smile on the face. I get a great deal of pleasure out of seeing the athletes enjoy themselves. It's serious business. They've trained and trained, and but, to see them actually enjoy it, it's, that's a whole new level of excitement, I think, for spectators, media, anybody watching, family. If you're doing it and not loving it, then why do you do it? And when you do see them show how much they enjoy what they're doing, completes the process in some ways. Ludmila Valchuk from Belarus on her way. Birgit Skarsten, 25-year-old from Oslo, also a rower. Silver medal last year at some rowing championships in Korea. Would like to go to Brazil as a rower for the Summer Paralympics. Oksana Masters. Going towards the middle of the field for the athletes here in the women's 1K sprint. We've seen a bit of Oksana in the biathlon events. Abdekarimova of Russia coming down to the line. Skarsten's 2:40 is the time to beat. Abdekarimova trying to challenge that time. Looks like she'll be just outside it though. 2:48, the next time to beat that of Rafaeva. Abdekarimova almost there. Yes, third position at the moment. And Kocharova of Russia slides into second ahead of Rafaeva and Abdekarimova. So Birgit Skarsten at the moment with the quickest time. Olena Yaskova. A lot of athletes to go. We've got 23 in this field for the women. Mariann Sheets of Belarus coming through. 2:40.5 to beat to slip it ahead of Skarsten. Put herself in contention for qualifying for the semis. Not far outside it. Into second position at the moment. Now, Tatyana McFadden. And saving hard to meet the expense of getting the family, biological family, down to watch her. What an emotional reunion it's been for her. What an emotional week for Anya Vicker. An incredible win in the biathlon for her. Tipped out some favourites. Put her best race together, didn't miss a target, comes away with gold. Now she's in the sprint in the cross country. Darchok. McFadden's now got the best time, 2:35.22. Darchok won't be challenging that, but third for the moment. Oksana Masters, very busy program for her. Just inside her fellow American, Tatyana McFadden. Both born in this part of the world. son of masters, adopted by an American family, as Tatyana was. Tatyana originally from Ukraine. Marta Zanulina. On away. And just got three to go after Marta. Offered a good clip too. Let's turn our attention back to the finish area, see who's coming down. Alina Yoskova. 6 seconds to get to the finish line ahead of Masters time of 2:34.81. She won't do that, Yoskova. Needs to push it home. You never know when that last effort might be worth a spot or missing out on one. And Yoskova, sixth position at the moment, 10 behind Masters. Now Colette Bourgogne of Canada. Andrea Eskow. Well, what a mixed game she's had. A gold medal in the early biathlon event and then two withdrawals. Yavlova in the third spot. Masters time holding up nicely. Mariann Marthinsen. Last to go in the women's 1K sprint sitting qualification. Nine-year-old from Bergen in Norway. In time, we've got Dicker down to the line. Dicker, she probably feels she anything she does from here on in is an absolute bonus after picking up gold in the biathlon. And Dicker the semis here. Sprint not really her event in the cross country, but what a great time she's having. Pavlenko. An easy tempo coming down to the line. She may not be going quick enough to make the semis. Zainulina into fourth position with a time of 2:37.89. Three down on Oksana Masters. The Masters went in the middle of the field and has really put up a good time there. Pozzolato has had a special ski designed by the automaker Ferrari, and she's a flying redhead atop a prancing horse. That's the story doing the rounds this week about Francesca Pozzolato, third last to go out of the gate. She's struggling a little to get near this time of Masters, which is standing up very well. Eskow has got the new quick time. She's had a bit of ill health this week, dealing with asthma. But, looks to be on top of it again. We hope so for her sake. Marthinsen, meanwhile, is about to take something out of Eskow's time. She's the top seed, and Marthinsen, there you are. She's the top qualifier ahead of Eskow, Masters, McFadden, Yavlova, and Zainulina. Scanning down the list, it looks like Natalia Kocharova has just made it. Yurt Yutkovska. Chiefs of Belarus and Dauchok. Here are the qualifiers for the men's. Petushkov, Yorogi, Murdigan, Zadapov, Klebel of Canada, Tuchenko, Ukraine, Lukyanenko, Belarus, Goncharov. Petushkov 2 seconds quicker than the next best. Then Nossen, Flyg, Sol, and Larsen. So the top 12 going through, just missing out by half a second, Dmitry Loban of Belarus. Unlucky. But the clock shows no sympathy. And there's a field of 24 who are looking to qualify, so the field has effectively been halved for the men's sprint sitting qualification. And the women have just finished. We'll have official confirmation of qualifiers in due course. Next on our program will be the men's 1K sprint standing classification. We'll look at Petrushkov. Tricky conditions. And the qualifications for the women's sprint. Marthinsen, as we've just seen. Oh, she's good there. Just 4 seconds quicker than Eskow. Masters, McFadden. Yovlova, Zanurina, Skarstein, Porcelato did make it. Valchok, Sheets, Yakovska, and Kocherova. A bit of a gap there back to Rafaeva. Field almost the same size as the men's, 23 this time, and down to 12 for the semis later in the day. So Marthinsen attack the course. Men's sprint standing category qualifying is next. So the athletes are doing their final stretches and warm-ups in the start area. Still the snow falls. Lushan Manegulov leads off the qualifiers. Lekomtsev, who surprisingly skipped the biathlon event we thought he might take part in. Govshinsky, Kodlozarov, Ukraine and Russia well represented. Norway, yeah, the Argentinian, Pablo Javier Robledo. Big field this one, 35 in it. Come from China, Poland, Finland, Mongolia's Ganbold Batmunk is here. Chinese are just blossoming into cross-country and triathlon skiing. Still a minute or so away from our scheduled start time. It's just past 10:30 in the morning Sochi time. More accurately, Laura time with the Laura Cross Country and Biathlon Centre, as I'm sure you're aware. It's been a wonderful host for us, Olympics and Paralympics. Vladimir Kononov. Kirill Mikhailov, Ihor Repchuk of Ukraine, all getting ready. Rushan Manegulov, 21-year-old, a Russian Federation, second at the 2013 Worlds. Couple of events, and so Manegulov is ready. He's off. and setting a good pace too. This is in the freestyle method of skiing. Vladislav Lekomsev, gold medalist in the 7.5K biathlon. Skipped the 12.5K for some reason, but here he is in the sprint. Setting off after Rushan Menegalov. 57 there, that's Tomisto, the leading Finn representative. Vladimir Kononov from the sport class LW57, and he skis without stocks and with an 88% factoring percentage applied to his time. Kirill Mikhailov won the 20K event in both Vancouver and Torino and the 2011 World Championship, so he's great over the longer distances. We'll go back to Lekomsev. Nice recent snow that's being splashed around the place as the athletes look to get a bit of a purchase going uphill. Really attacking this one. Well, why not? It's only a kilometre. Go hard or go home, they say. Ihor Rybchuk of Ukraine, a 19-year-old. He's also very good over the distance events. Third at the 2013 World Championships over 20 kilometres. So stamina here won't be an issue. There for this man, who is Yoshihiro Nitta. Now we've got the right guy away. And Nitta, 33-year-old, taking part in his fourth Paralympic Winter Games. 60 there, Hakon Olsrud. Somewhere under those umbrellas was a group of Japanese fans. Look at Tomisto. Third Paralympic Winter Games for Ilkka from Tampere in Finland. Had a third in the sprint in Vancouver 4 years ago. Meanwhile, looking at Rushan Menegalov coming around into the home straight. First to finish, first to start. These interval starts, 30 seconds between the athletes. So we'll get an early clue about a benchmark time as Menegalov makes his way through the driving snow towards the finish. And Menegalov, well, it's hard to clap when you're holding an umbrella, but the voices sound pretty good in his ears, I'm sure. Menegalov, 3:40. Let's see how that time stacks up as the rest of the field comes through. And it is a big field today. 35 athletes chasing 12 positions in the semis. Lekomsev. We saw him really attacking the hills. And Lekomsev, not yet 20 years of age, three gold medals at the 2013 World Championships, including the 1K sprint. And he's just quicker than Menegalov. Ooh, they'll be a good pair if we see them in later races, semis or final perhaps. On Olsrud, he's on his way from Oslo, 28-year-old cross-country skier. Here comes Vladimir Kononov, skating his way to the line. Might be just outside the Lekomsev's 3:39.25. will be. Oh, the last few strides, pretty hard work. Fun love. Okay, Yov coming down also outside the concept time. So the Lekomtsev's 3:39, holding up quite well. Grigory Vovshinsky of Ukraine next to leave the gate. Ivorotchuk, 3:45, the tick clocking, and the clock ticking past that, so Lekomtsev. The seated skiers going first in this class. Starting to suggest no one might beat that. But Russia 1-2-3-4 at the moment. Podlazarov, out of the Russian Federation. He's on his way. 56 is Yoshihiro Nitta. A bit of a challenge to your focus and concentration with the snow in your face. And conditions a bit tricky under the skis as well. And certainly different to what they've been skiing in. Nothing they haven't seen before, but not what they've been skiing on the last few days. Tuomisto, I think, coming down in a pretty brisk time. And the top five result for the moment for Tuomisto. That looks good for qualification prospects. Tino Ulib of Germany scurries away from the start area. ...37-year-old from Weisbronn in Germany. Davier of France down towards the finish now. That's a good time. That's a top five. He's only 5.3 seconds down on the Lekomtsev. Lapkin. Sergei Lapkin. A bit of a sprint specialist. And there he is. We've got a new quick time. And from Lapkin. He's really put it out there. Quite a challenge for the athletes to pace themselves through the day. When they know that if they're going to make a final and do well in it, it's going to involve three races. So you can't give all you've got in the first, but you've got to give enough to qualify for the semi and then the final. Sergei Lapkin with a new quickest time of 3:35.4. Osrud looking for top 10 position here, but it's slipping away from him. Maybe 4.4 seconds outside the quickest time. Silshanka next to go from Belarus. I have to say, Sergei Lapkin's best time, it comes a little against his recent form. There's not much to suggest he should have been that quick. He's been obviously training well. He had an 8th in the 1K sprint at the World Championships 3 years ago. We should go back to Sergei Silshanka on his way. Karachurin coming through. Might just make the top 12. We'll have to wait and see. Still plenty to come in. Quite a few to start if we turn our attention back to the gate. Lassi Kankunen. Here comes it. Podlazarov. Ivan Podlazarov. To get into the top 10. That's passed him by. And Lazarov, well, he's not going to stay in the top 12, I'd suggest, but if everybody else behind him struggles, maybe he will. Witold Skupien from Poland is on his way. Another from the W57 sport class. Martinovic. He's ready. Belarusian on his way. Well, at the Winter Games, you should see some snow. We've had rain, we've had sun, we've had cloud, and finally, the snow is falling. It's rather wet stuff. Sato. Kaichi Sato. Well, this isn't too quick. That's not going to get him into the semis. 42 seconds down. Zudexin. Chinese athlete on his way. Got a few from China today. We've got the Chan Ye. Ulig for Germany down to the line outside the top 12. Yu Jianhui of China also. And Cheng Shishui. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from China in the field today for the sprint qualifying. Ostrenko just outside the top 12. Sure whether we're going to have any change to the 12 at the moment. Well, yes, we will. Pronkov is going to force his way in. It's a very good lap from Pronkov into second place. Just started to wonder whether there was anyone who could challenge those in the top 12. We've got one. Pronkov, great time. Second best. And it's now Russia. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 best qualifiers. Lapkin, Pronkov, Lekomtsev, Menegalov, Mikhailov, Omar Bermejo, the United States on his way. Robledo, the Argentinian coming down. For 12.79. From Mongolia, Ganbal Batmunk. Sushanka, 4 minutes just gone on his clock, so he's outside the top 12, but inside the time of Robledo by a couple of seconds. Next of our Chinese competitors, Tian Ye. So, 8 to come after Tian. And the times varying between 3:35 and up to 4:20. 4:20 the slowest time so far, that belonging to Tina Ulig of Germany. Kankinen in 4:12. Louis Fortin of Canada gets the green light. It's old Skupien coming through. Coming up towards 4 minutes. Again, he's going to just miss that crucial top 12 to go through. At the moment, it's utterly dominated by the host nation. We've got Russia 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. 8 of the top 10, 8 of the top 12 from the Russian Federation. Martinovic working his way towards the line. He's not worried about his own position, just his own performance. And it's 43 seconds outside Lapkin's very brisk 3:35. Rudek Zin about to come across the line. Quite hard making your own track through this this newly fallen snow, and it was all a bit much for Zudek Shin. In the 82 bib, it's Keigo Iwamoto of Japan. It's looking like a snowplow there as he just carves his way away from the start area. 74 is Chen Shishui. Seconds outside Lapkin's time. I think these competitors who have a strong sense of where they sit in the field, not probably going to make the top 12, they do give it absolutely everything because they're not going to have something in reserve for later. So they really are spent when they get to the line. Michael Kurtz made himself very popular at these games with his wonderful attitude. He just loves competing, and it's written all over his face. It may be harder to see it today. A 40-year-old Austrian. 7 top tens at the world's in cross-country events. Also competes in biathlon. And he's the last man to go. It's Yerlan Omarov of Kazakhstan. And he was Kazakhstan's flag bearer at these games, at the opening ceremony. Back to the finish. And another Kazakhstan athlete has crossed the line in Kolyarin. So everyone has either finished or is still out on the course. Romeo of the United States working his way down to the finish. Minute 13 down on Lapkin, Batmunk. Very energetic style he brings to his cross-country skiing. Bermejo of the United States originally came from Guadalajara. Yes, the umbrella's a popular accoutrement today. We shake the snow off it. It gets heavier and heavier. Like snow on the roof. You want to get it off before the thing collapses. Tianye. Down to the line he comes. Also not a qualifier. Let's read them out for you as they stand at the moment because they may not change. Lapkin, Pronkov, Lekomtsev, Menegilov, Mikhailov, all from the Russian Federation, the top five. Then France's Benjamin Davier. Two more Russians in Kononov and Katachurin. From Ukraine, Govshinsky, Tuomisto of Finland, Repchuk, Ukraine, and Yoshihiro Nitta of Japan. Canadian flag being waved again. But, regret to inform them that the Canadians don't have anyone in the top 12 yet. Probably won't have. Du Haitao. He's come through. Congratulations of his Chinese teammate Chen Shishui as he moved past. And they continue to enjoy the great camaraderie between these athletes in cross country and biathlon. Enormous respect that they have for each other. John Oman of the USA. Oops. You get up and you can see the funny side of it. And as John comes down to the line, the crowd cheering for him. It's been a tough kilometer, I think, for John, who's from Hudson, Wisconsin. Also plays a bit of amputee hockey, the 35-year-old, and he's not been into this cross-country game for too long. Well, fell within sight of the finish, but that's all right. He's got up and got across the line. And he's proud to be here, I'm sure. Lapkin, 335.40, still holding up. Just looking at my screen, they might only be allowing 8 through as qualifiers here instead of 12. Not sure why that might be. So only as far down as Katachurian, which means 1, 2, 7 out of the 8 qualifiers at the moment are from the Russian Federation. Good chance they'll sweep the medals, I'd suggest to you. Iwamoto, 1:23 behind Lapkin's time. And Yu Jianhui comes through in just over 5 minutes. Here's our Austrian friend, Michael Kurtz, from Lienz. Ah, now my screen has changed, and we do have 12, we've got at least 11 qualifiers. I've added Wyszynski to a Mr. and Repchuk. I'm just surprised if we don't get 12. Just a little computer glitch, perhaps. We still do have one very strong Russian contingent qualifying for the next stage. Yelan Omarov of Kazakhstan. Working his way down towards the line. The flag bearer for his nation at the opening ceremony of these Paralympic Winter Games. And the crowd keeping themselves warm with yelling out their approval of the athlete's effort. And Omarov makes it. So that's everybody out of this pretty big field of 35. And we have got 12 now. And Yoshihiro Nitta looks like he's the lucky number 12 from Japan. Lapkin, Pronkov, Lekomtsev, Minegalov, Mikhailiev, all from the Russian Federation, the top five. Then Benjamin Davier spoils the party, but only briefly. Two more Russians, Vladimir Kononov and Azat Karachurin. Then Grigory Lovchinsky, followed by Ilka Tuomisto, Ihor Repchuk, and Yoshihiro Nitta, rounding out our top 12, who will qualify for the semifinals. Competition rolls on. Next up, the women's sprint standing qualification. We have 17 starters in this one. They've all made it to the start area. Elena Kaufman will start as favorite. Alexandra Kononova, Yulia Batenkova, Anna Malanina, all medalists so far in other competitions, biathlon or cross country. Canada, Japan, Ukraine, Norway, all well represented. Yelena Mazurenko of Kazakhstan will be last to go. Elena Kaufman, gold medals in the 6K and 10K biathlon. This is cross-country, though, and it's a sprint. And probably not as strong for her as the biathlon is. although she's enjoying these Paralympic Winter Games, I know she can't wait to get back with the family, her young daughter, Karina, husband Mark. Alexandra Kononova. She's pretty quick. 22-year-old from Brovary in Ukraine. Won the sprint classic trial with Kononova in Vancouver, but we're watching Kaufman out of one of the early quicker sections of the course. It's not long, but it is challenging, especially in these conditions. Yulia Batenkova, next to go. Third Paralympic Winter Games for her. A couple of minor placings here. 4 seconds and 3/3 prior to Sochi. So Batenkova continuing to find herself on the podium. Just wants that top spot, just once. Might it be in the sprint, no later in the day. Anna Malenina, second place in the women's 6K biathlon. One of the tougher climbs of this short 1K course. Shoko Ota. 24 years of age from Tokyo. She was second in the sprint in Vancouver, so we should pay some attention to Shoko Ota, although it was in the classic style. Doesn't mean though, she's got good sprint muscles. Helene Oripa. Has already won the 15K. So she's a gold medalist already, the Swede, who's taken up the sport quite late at 42. So a little downhill section before the last work to the finish line. This is when the athletes are really trying to get the oxygen reloaded into the system. Natalia Bratyuk, the Russian Federation, she's only 16. And in the 10K biathlon, the bronze medalist. And she's the youngest athlete on the Russian Federation Paralympic Winter Games team. She's proved to be very good very early. Larissa Varona, 31-year-old Belarusian. Fourth in the sprint in Vancouver was Varona. Just missed a medal 4 years ago. What about in 2014? Maya Javala in Finland. 29-year-old is competing in six events here, three in the biathlon, three in the cross country. Elena Kaufman making this right-hand sweeping turn into the home straight in front of the grandstand as the snow continues to fall. The umbrella's still up. But for the Russian Federation athletes, there's plenty of cheering going on. Kaufman to set the initial time, and we'll see how close the rest can get to it. Should have 12 go through out of the field of 17, so they don't have to lose too many. I think Kaufman will be there when the whips are cracking, as they say in some parts of the world. 4:44.93. Kononova looks like she's finding it hard work today, but that's the snow in the face. That doesn't help your general demeanor. But Kononova, she's got Kaufman's time, well beaten. Ludmila Lyashenko next to go for Ukraine. Tenkova should be next to come into the finish area. The snow's getting wetter and wetter. And it won't be long before it's rain if you're not careful. But Tenkova, second position at the moment. That ought to be strong enough to see her through to the next stage. Qualifying, semis, and then finals. It is one of the busier days for the cross-country and biathlon centre as Milanina forges away down these last few metres. Kononova and 4:32.87 is the time to beat. So Milanina just outside it. Good first display from her. Oh, we've got an athlete down, and I think that's Helene Ripper. Oh, she's got a face full of snow. Hope she's able to continue and still post a good time. She's in great form, Ripper, having picked up a gold medal in the 15K. Ota, a Japanese competitor with good form from 4 years ago. Ota just in fifth position now. We've only had five finishes. So Brittany Hudak of Canada is on her way. She'll be followed by Caroline Bisson, also of Canada, and then Yelena Mazurenko. Hudak from Prince Albert, Saskatchewan. Concerned that we haven't got a time in or a finish for Helene Ripper, the Swedish competitor who had a fall. Kononova, 4:32.87, time to beat. Bratjuk coming through, the 16-year-old is full of admiration for how well she's done so early in what I hope is a long career for her. And sixth. Got a couple of qualifiers already. Just got the word too that Caroline Bisson of Canada is not a starter today. So that's trimmed the field to 16. And if Ripa has not continued after the fall, that's 15. It might mean only a few miss out. Oh, here she is, Ripa, coming into view. And looks as though she's struggling after that fall, but it's worth trying to make your way to the line in case some others struggle, and she can gather herself together before the semis. If she makes it, then things might pick up for her. Well, Ripa really did have a nasty fall, and across she comes a minute 17 outside Kononova's time. So Ripa is the slowest at the moment. Jaavola threw in fourth best. Alyssa Verona will be faster than Ripa. So it could be that fall for Helene Ripa costs her a place in the semis, and that's desperately bad luck. You're not really expecting to fall in a kilometre, but the snow is so soft that it builds up. Oh, well, there we go. There's another one, and it's Irina Buey of Ukraine, but she's quickly to her feet. Oh, again, come on, up it gets, keep going. That's the way, Irina. Get yourself to the finish. The snow is really tricky now. It's soft, it's just building up, and as the legs tire, she's across there in the eighth position, and she'll be cursing this surface. It is really tricky now, especially when the legs are fatiguing and not quite behaving as you want them to. Momoko Dekajima. She's there in eighth position. Yashenko, that's a nice time of 4:41.60. puts her in fourth position. We've got eight qualifiers so far. Hard to pick up who's who in this driving snow. But, this should be Monika Abe. It is. Abe's time ought to squeeze her into the top 12. Just got to keep her feet, keep driving on to the finish here. And might be touch and go for her, but I think she's going to be good enough. 5 minutes. Pretty much on the button. And Abe. And they certainly haven't come here not to give of their best. And you see the effort that's going into this for qualifying. Even if it feels like they don't have a chance of making the top 12, they're giving it absolutely everything. And Olsen, Anna Karen Olsen. The younger ones here, just 19 years of age now. Had a birthday in late February. Brittany Hudak. She's inspired to take up cross-country skiing by another Canadian athlete, Colette Bergogna, who came to the shop where she was working and said, come on, you try the sport. And she did, and she's here. And who that, depending on Mazarenko's time, might just be qualifying, who that. But there won't be any room, unfortunately, for Helena Ripper. Ripper, who's had a high price for the fall. So semi-final places for the top 12. And we've got 11 of them confirmed, just waiting for Mazurenko, our last starter, to come across the line. And here she is. Irina Mazurenko. Asked if she ever had any superstitions. No, I've never had any real superstitions before the start of competition. The only thing I do is think about my family. Well, that's very sweet. And Mazurenko is not really on race pace here. I think she will be one to miss out. From Kazakhstan. Paraganda. So it looks like we have Kononova, Melenina, Potenkova, Ukraine, Russia, Ukraine, Lyashenko of Ukraine. So Ukraine with three of the top four. Then Maya Yavala, Elena Kaufman, Russian Federation, Choko Ota of Japan, Brachuk, Russia, Abe and Dekajima of Japan. So Japan with three in the top 12. Then Anna Karen Olsen of Norway. And I think we can reasonably confidently say that the last qualifier will be Brittany Hudak of Canada. So not so very far to go for Yelena Mazurenko of Kazakhstan. Crowd finding voice for her. She's doing the sprint, the 5K and the relay. And this is the first of her three events. Almost into the home straight for Yelena Mazurenko. Looking at the qualifying times at Kononova of Ukraine, came through almost 5 seconds quicker than the next best, Anna Melanina of the Russian Federation, and she a couple of seconds quicker than Potenkova. But at first look, Kononova is going to be tough to beat. We've got semis to come, and then finals. And between then and now, we've got other qualifying to get through the vision impaired races. So this is such a busy day at Lauda, with heats, semis and finals. Men and women sitting, standing and vision impaired. Yelena Mazarenko of Kazakhstan coming down in 7:44.9, and that indeed confirms that Brittany Hudak of Canada gets the last qualifying position for the semis. Next up, the men's sprint visually impaired qualification. They gathered. More snow attaching itself to the trees here. And here's the start list. Choklaev, Makiva, Palukin, Modin, all skiing very well here. We've seen from earlier events. Eric Bayer from Norway. Adakov and Burton from the US. Clementi from Finland here. Stanislav Choklaev leads him away with his guide, Maxim Pirogov. He's in the B1 category. The least amount of sight, if not blind, and so 87% is his factoring. And the great Brian McKeever. Well, what hasn't been said about this giant of the sport? A dozen world championships, 8 Paralympic Winter Games gold medals, mainly in cross-country as he enjoyed success. He has had a bronze medal in Torino in biathlon, but Makiva is just a dominant figure in the sport. Nikolai Palukin, Andrei Tokarev is his guide, so they'll go hard at it, these men, around the 1 kilometer course. Very difficult for the vision impaired athletes to pick up the little nuances in the surface as it continues to change as the snow falls. There are little build-ups of loose soft snow that have tripped up the odd athlete, and that's Sebastian Modin heading off next. Lots to like about this young 19-year-old Swedish competitor. He was only 15, competed in Vancouver, and he picked up the bronze in the sprint. So 4 years later, that much stronger, that much more experienced. I wonder what he'll do here. Thomas Clarion from Bonvie in France. He's off and on his way. Just reassuring you, they're not getting a toe there. They're both gliding downhill, so just making sure that the skier doesn't run into the guide. It's all above board. You don't need to worry about thinking if that's legal or not. It's a common practice in this sport. Oleg Ponomarev. His guide is Andrei Romanov. He's only 21 years of age, Oleg. Gets a big cheer from the Russian crowd as he sets off. Nominative. Just thought about him. He did come third at last year's World Championships. Vasily Shapshiboy. He's competing in both the biathlon and cross-country, and made the observation about him, if he was a better shooter, he'd win more biathlon events because he's a very good skier. And cross-country, he's had silver and bronze medal finishes in Torino and Vancouver. Not so much the sprint, though. Tends to like the longer distances, but I think he is good enough. Moden, meanwhile, has already added up some time around the course. It's a pretty impressive stuff from Moden. And Makiva. Makiva, I beg your pardon, not Moden. Makiva coming down to the line. Going to be first to post the time. .332.51. Chaplayev started 30 seconds in front of Makiva, but this is an opportunity for you to observe how the factoring system works. Chaplayev, 87% applied to his real time to give us his official time, as he is in the B1 class. So Brian Makiva, the most sight out of the visually impaired sports classes, he's B3. And for Brian, 100% of his real time counts for his official time. Palukin is in the B2 class, and so 98% of his real time applies. So we've got three athletes from the three different visually impaired classes going out first. But Makiva, 3:32.51. Oh, we've got a fall here. And that was Palukin. Nikolai Palukin, and he wasn't far from the finish when that happened. He's got a face full of snow and a smile on his face. Now we've got Sebastian Moden coming through in the white Swedish uniform. Moden also in the B1 sport class. The outside Makiva's time, possibly inside Choclayev. Yes, he is. So second position at the moment for Moden. 18 starters in the men's visually impaired qualification. 106, Oleg Ponomarev. And Ponomarev coming through in 3:32.93. He's very close to Makiva's time. He was certainly easing up on the line. Oh, and another fall. These conditions are tough. There's so much loose snow in the home straight here. And Clarion of France, Thomas, a fall not far from the line. I hope those few seconds he lost there don't cost him a place. That's a tough break. Rudolf Clementi, Timo Salmonen providing the guiding duties. Bulgarian boys going last and second last. Zelyas Kolev and Svetoslav Georgiev. Last minute massage to the shoulders. Keep the man nice and loose and ready. Dutch boy from Belarus. Now he's not as quick as I thought he might be. Look down his results to see the better ones do come in the middle distance events. He's 40 seconds slower than Makiva. So we'll have to see whether that's going to be good enough. But Chatsuboy, has he had a fall? Yes, he has. But that was across the tips there. And anyone who's skied knows that's that usually means you're coming to ground. I don't know that we blame the snow that time so much as his technique, but Artemov, sixth position. So Makiva, Ponomarev, Moden, Russia, so Canada, Russia, Sweden at the moment. And then there's a host of Russian competitors after Moden. Choklayev, Udoltkov, Artemov, and Palukin. So the host nation could have another strong result here, but they will have trouble shifting Makiva from that top spot. Like the look of Ponomarev's race, he, I mentioned, looked like he had plenty in reserve. Shuga of Ukraine comes through in the middle of a squad of four Russians behind Modin. And Svetoslav Georgiev is on his way. Final competitor in the men's 1K visually impaired sprint qualification. 111, Erik Bye of Norway. Whether 4 minutes is going to be good enough? I think it might be. Out on the course and coming in shortly will be Adakoff and Burton, Panetti. And indeed, here comes Jacob Adakoff. So he's just pushed Shaps, your boy, down to 12th. Erik Bye 11th at the moment. I think Adakoff is safe at 3:49. Microphones out on the course. Do a great job of conveying to you at home, if you're familiar with snow and the different types, just how soft that sounds. It's not a cold day by alpine standards. 2 or 3 degrees. The snow is soft, but at least we're getting some. Quite a lot of rain yesterday, but it's barely snow now. It's sort of a sleety, snowy, rainy kind of thing. It's not helping visibility or enjoyment for spectators, but they do appreciate the efforts of the athletes. As Kevin Burton makes his way down towards the line. Kevin Burton from Boulder, Colorado. Snow in the beard. A shake of the head. Oh, I'm not sure that was much fun, he says. He's got some support here, though. Rudolf Clemetti. No, he's not going to make it. Neither will Burton. That time we just saw posted, so Clemetti not quick enough today. We have a top 12 to go through. We can confirm that the first four are already through without question. Makiva, Ponomarev, Modin and Chokolayev. Canada, Russia, Sweden, Russia. Kanafin is finished. Now Vladimir Adoltkov, that means he's definitely through. So as these athletes finish well outside the qualifying time, it just locks another one of the faster skiers into a qualifying position at the semis. 116 there. Choi of Korea, Choi Bogue. Choi coming into the home straight. His guide is Xiao John Moon. And Choi was named best performer at the 11th Winter National Sports Festival for athletes with impairments in Korea. And he won 2 gold medals. That was early 2012. Excellent to see him here. He's going to be in the sprint and the 10K. And he won't be in the semi-finals of the sprint. Is from Seoul. And he'll be looking forward to a home Winter Paralympics in Pyeongchang in 4 years' time. Svetoslav Georgiev. Father got him involved in the sport. He's 25 years of age now, from Gabrovo in Bulgaria. Georgiev being steered home by his guide, Ivan Bernikov. And it's his teammate, Zelyaz Kolev, we're waiting for to finish the field. And Hungarian is a little bit of a way to go. Still finding it a bit of a struggle out there. But Zelyaz Kolev, a young man, 17 years of age. Women's visually impaired cross-country qualifying is about to start. Just 7 in it, so I'm assuming that means we've just got to drop one off for the final, but I'll wait for the officials to sort that out for me. Zelyaz Kolev. Still to complete the men's qualifying. Getting plenty of encouragement. Tricky little downhill section in the wet, snowy, stormy kind of blowy conditions we've got. Guide right beside him, so I think we can suggest to you he's only a novice at this form of skiing, but it's great to see him here. He's still in his teens. What an opportunity. Whoops. And he's going to fight his way to the finish, and the crowd will certainly appreciate that he has. In the soft snow, the difficult conditions, and the occasion, I guess, for someone so young. Just 17 years of age. Start of the women's 1K sprint, visually impaired qualification, and off at a good pace. Elena Remizova. Gold in the 15K cross-country, fourth in the 6K biathlon. Already got one gold medal then, has Remizova. Robbie Weldon of Canada gives the world a wave. But next to go, Mikkelina Lisova. Double gold medalist already at these games, and a silver. Lisova has won the 6 and 10K biathlon gold medals and silver in the 15K cross-country. A bit of a star of the Russian Paralympic Winter Games team. Yulia Budalieva. Couple of silver medals for Yulia in the 6 and 10K biathlon. She's 23 years of age from Tumen in Russia. And Zelyaz Kolev has finished the race. Good to see. Robbie Weldon from Thunder Bay in Canada. That's a great name for a place. And she's being guided by Phil Wood. 38-year-old is going in the 1K sprint, the 5K, and the relay. Oksana Shishkova. She's collected 2 bronze medals so far, but they're in biathlon events, the 6 and 10K, and here she is in the sprint with Lara Nestorenko, her guide. She'll be attacking the first 100 metres or so, see if she can keep up this good pace. She's got the confirmation of how many athletes drop out of this smallish field of 7 through qualifying. Vivian Hosch of Germany, next to go. sleep with the guiding duties for Vivian. Yulia Budalieva. It's a tough climb. It's only 1 kilometre, but 1 kilometre race circuit, but this hill tends to sort them out. And Margarita Gobunova, a Canadian, born in St. Petersburg. Family moved to Russia. Both her parents are accomplished skiers, internationally so. And Margarita has been having a go at both biathlon and cross country. And I think you can, with some confidence on form, say that Remizova, Lisova and Shishkova will be around podium finish times. Budalieva, perhaps. Not sure about Robbie Weldon. We've not seen the Canadian until now in the sprint. So Budalieva holding form together quite nicely. A couple of silver medals already in biathlon. My concern for Mikhailina Lisova is that she's had such a busy program. How her stamina will hold up for three races. Well, it might only be two for this category. Anyway, Remizova, the Russian Federation, coming down to the line, first out of the gate and first to finish. And see how the others deal with the time that she sets. Mikhailina, 27-year-old from Tumen, 424.93. Certainly gave it plenty. She's not mucking around, making sure she qualifies for the next stage. Now Mikhailina Lisova. She'll be 22 later this month. Almost 6 seconds quicker than Remizova. So it has a calm look about it. So everything's under control. Budalieva, she's also coming in a similar time. This is looking good for a tight race come the final of the women's 1K, visually impaired. So she'll be just outside 4:20 and splitting Lisova and Remizova. Yes, she does. Barely, but just inside Remizova's time. Robbie Weldon, Oksana Shishkova next to come in. Robbie Weldon doesn't have Shishkova far behind her. There's a little communication system going between Weldon and Phil Wood, her guide. Little speaker on the back of his belt. Robbie Weldon in the B2 category, the middle of the visually impaired classes. She's coming down to the line in about 5 minutes, so she's outside the early pace of Lisova and Budalieva. Remizova looks like she's going to be safe. Weldon in, 40 seconds down on Lisova. Shishkova will be quicker than Weldon. So now we've got four qualifiers confirmed in Lisova, Budalieva, Remizova, all of the Russian Federation, then Shishkova of Ukraine. Waiting on the times of Vivian Hirsch and Margarita Gobunova. There's not much between them. And they'll be across the line soon enough. So we've got five finished, four qualified, two to come in. And although Gobunova is very close to Hirsch and may even overtake her in the straight, let's remember that Hirsch is in the B1 class and will have 13% of her actual time carved off her real time. Just going to make sure there's no incident here as four people, two guides and two athletes coming down the line at the same time. Hirsch and Gudbunova. Weldon's time 4:59.91. Hirsch. Gets there. Inside that time. Gudbunova. Doesn't. So it looks like Margarita Gudbunova is going to be the one to miss out. There's six to go through. That's bad luck. It was a close thing. But, she's missed out, I think, with three Russians. Shishkova of Ukraine, Hirsch of Germany, and Robbie Weldon of Canada. We get one Canadian through. So confirming some qualifying for you from the men's sprint sitting. Petushkov, a couple of seconds quicker than Yurovyi. Murugin, Zadapov, Klebel, Tchenko, Mikinenko, Goncharov. Then Nossen of USA, Flyg, Germany, Sol, USA, Larsen of Norway. And just missing out by half a second, Dmitry Loban of Belarus. Women's sprint sitting qualifiers, Marthinsen of Norway, easily the quickest. Eskow of Germany. From the US, Masters and McFadden. From Russian Federation, Yovlova Zanulina, Skarstein of Norway, Pozzolato of Italy, Vauchok, Belarus, Sheets of Belarus, Yoksova Kosherova from Ukraine and Russian Federation. So most of these fields being trimmed to 12, and in the case of the women's visually impaired, just down to 6. Due to the fact it's just a small field. Men's sprint standing qualifying. Big day for Russia here. Lapkin, Pronkov, Lekomtsev, Menegilov, Mikhailov, all from the Russian Federation. Top five. Darvier of France. Kononov, Karachurin also there for Russia. Tomisto of Finland, Repchuk and Nitta of Japan. Quite a big field, this one. So unfortunately, that means quite a few missed out. But great experience, especially for those young Chinese cross-country skiers, just new to the sport. Women's sprint, standing qualifiers, Kononova, Milanina, Potenkova, Lyashenko, all the favourites moving through. Yavra, Kaufman, Shoka Oto, Bratchuk, the 16-year-old Russians made it. Yurika Abe of Japan, along with her teammate Ota, will be there in the next stage, the semi-finals. Dekajima, so three Japanese through to the semis, Olsen of Norway and Hudak of Canada. They're all through. Men's sprint, Makiva, impressive, so too Ponomarev. Then a bit of a gap back to the time of Sebastian Modin of Sweden, Shoklayev, Daltkov, Shulga, Artemov, and Adakov. So they've allowed 8 through. Might be 2 semis of 4 there, I think, that being the case. We'll see. And the women's visually impaired qualifying, release of that and the delay of that of Russian Federation and Remizova. So 1-2-3 for the Russian Federation there. Shishkova of Ukraine has made it. Hirsch of Germany and Robbie Weldon of Canada. So the next stage, the first of the semi-finals, is due to happen in about 40 minutes time. Look forward to your company then. Thank you.